Hello everybody, welcome back. My name is Rainbow, this is Megzy.
Hi!
And this is a game we've been waiting to play for a very long time. This was originally a French game. It is known as Off. It's an RPG. And at one point I might have Megzy just take over because I'm not good with RPGs, but I'm going to give it my best shot. And this is not a game that's a blind playthrough. We know about this game.
We love this game. It was based on a game, well, everybody knows. It was based on Earthbound, or at least the style was. So it's kind of like if Earthbound was a horror game. What do I mean, if it was a horror game?
Yeah, I was going to say, it's like if.
If Earthbound was weirder than it already is. And this game is very symbolic. We will do our best not to spoil anything because the reveal at the end is so good and so subtle and so well done that we don't want to spoil anything. But feel free to discuss in the comments what you think is going on, I guess. And also be careful because some jerks in the comment might spoil the whole thing.
Yes, please, if you've seen this game being played, if you've played this game yourself, please try not to spoil it. My cat is trying to get in her bed.
This game is also highly symbolic and highly subjective. So there are several different interpretations for what the game means and what's going on and what's really going on. So again, feel free to discuss. We have what we think is what it means, what all the symbolism means. Which we'll discuss at the end of the game. It's not a very long game, so. But, feel free to discuss. It's a great game. I'm really excited to finally get to play it on the channel.
We are actually also playing this at the same time as we're playing Undertale. The reason why is because a lot of people have compared... This game came first, and then Undertale came later. The reason why a lot of people have actually compared these two games together... I'm not really sure why.
They're very different games. I have heard that they are similar in gameplay, but the fact is that that they're both inspired by Earthbound / Mother 3, and that they're an RPG, and that's really where the similarities end. But since we're playing them at the same time, it'll be fun to be able to compare them. And I think also on our Throwback Thursday, we're going to start playing Earthbound.
We are going to start playing Earthbound.
So it might just be RPG January. Who knows?
Yeah, we'll give it a shot. Okay. Let's go.
So let's go. This text is hard to read. Please use... We did that already. Rather,
I'm good.
I was sitting over Rainbow's shoulder like, okay, install that. Okay, click this. No, you can't take it out of the folder. Certain scenes of the game are shocking to an unwarned public. Or maybe not. Musical pieces and sound effects of Off created by alias Conrad Coldwood are an important part of the game. It would be a shame to play without them. Ain't that the truth?
That is true. If you are playing this game for yourself, do not turn the sound off. The noises and sound and just all of the audio is extremely important.
And also, I should point out, this game is free.
You can play
this game for free.
This game is free.
And
Undertale is $10, not on sale.
Earthbound, good luck getting a cartridge.
Emulators are free.
Emulators are illegal, which is why we don't use them.
We don't use them at all.
Legit copies of old games. Anyway, this game is free. I'm going to say this right now. If you haven't played it, go play it for yourself. Make your own conclusions about what's going on. This game is so good. Okay, I'm gonna stop geeking out. I'm gonna actually... Unproductive fun time. I'm gonna actually, you know...
And to your name... Oh, Rainbow! Can I just...
You can be Rainbow.
Rimber! Oh, I have to actually, do it this way. Okay.
I know in Undertale, you ran out of room, so you're just Rainbow without the W.
Yeah. Hey!
Can you have exclamation marks? Oh, damn it. I was hoping you'd be like, Rainbow! Oh!
Ah! I can be Rainbow Pisces!
Do you have exclamation points? Yes, you do. You should be like, yay. You're Rainbow. Yay! Happy fun times! Happy fun game! The smiley face.
Sad face.
Yeah, right? Okay. Your name is Rainbow, correct?
Yes.
Are you a boy or are you a girl, Rainbow?
I'm yes.
Yes, you are? All right, well, I'm a girl. Girl. All right. All right.
They should have a gender neutral.
Yeah, they really should. Welcome,
Rainbow! Period.
You have been assigned to a being. Do you want to read this or should I?
You've been assigned to a being called the Batter. The Batter has an important mission. Be sure it's accomplished. We will let you out of zone. We'll let you out in zone zero. Good luck.
Thank you.
For more information, find the one called the Judge.
Who could the Judge be?
Pablo!
What?
What? Off. It took us forever to figure out what this meant. It's like, why is it called off? I don't understand. I'm the Batter, by the way. I think Megzy's gonna do all the other voices.
Yeah, I gotta come up with a voice for everybody.
Yeah. To move my body, use the arrow keys on your keyboard.
What's your voice gonna be like for the Batter? Just gonna be like that?
I think he's just like... To interact with the environment, use the space bar or the enter key. I think I'm gonna, like, just the... Everything is final countdown time.
Everything is really serious. Yeah. Alright.
Ah, little sprite things. So cute. Okay. I'm sorry if my mouse is clicky.
Zone zero.
I have a very clicky mouse. Or a clicky keyboard.
Oh, the noises. I love them.
Cat!
There cannot be any other living beings in zone zero, so I must assume that you are a mere figment of my imagination. Nevertheless, I will introduce myself. I am the Judge, and I am aching to know your name, dear illusory interlocutor. I don't know.
I'm really glad you're the one doing the Judge.
I gotta try not to do Markiplier's like fancy Judge.
Yeah, I don't know. That works. I'm the Batter. I have been assigned to a sacred mission.
It is a pleasure. However, it is not the puppet I was addressing, but the puppeteer controlling it. What is your name, dear puppeteer?
Her name is Rainbow! She can't talk to us. However, she can hear and see everything.
Even though you
kitty purred! Did you hear the kitty?
No, I was too busy. I was too busy getting ready to
I'm
be.
Sorry, the cat. This cat purred.
Wait, which cat?
The cat in game purred.
I'm sorry. We have three cats here and one cat in game, so I'm like, who's purring? Okay. Even though you too are but an inexistent apparition in my eyes, let it be said that I am delighted to meet you as well, dear Rainbow.
I believe we're in need of your services.
Many people are in need of my services, you know. Everybody loves cats. We rub ourselves against their legs and purr in the most insistent manner. They adore that.
Don't we just? I'm not talking about that kind of help.
You could use that kind of help better. I see, but what sort of service could I offer to an ectoplasmic entity?
I have a sacred mission to fulfill. I must purify the world. It's the final cat. Sorry.
There is no objective more laudable than yours. I accept to serve you as a guide through this area, if it is of any help to you.
Thanks. Whoa, he just magicianed himself up.
A luck ticket.
Yay!
I'm gonna sneeze.
Zoom tight. Oh, we're gonna need to write crap down, aren't we?
Here, I'm just gonna take pictures on my phone.
Alright.
Okay.
Cat!
Oh, it did purr.
Every time you talk to him, he purrs.
Oh, allow me to confess that I find you quite tangible for a phantasmagorical being. Might you, in fact, be a creature of flesh and blood?
I think so. Yes.
Wow! So I have been mistaken from the beginning. You did not even interrupt me in my deluded phantasms. This is relatively bizarre, I must say, for you are the first living being I was given a chance to encounter in this Lieu. I don't know. And I had in fact concluded that Zone Zero was an empty land. Obviously, I was misled. However, there exist other zones, and in those territories, the risk of hostile individuals attacking you in the most violent manner is quite high. Your sacred mission will likely lead you into these lands. Would you like me to teach you the art of violent confrontation? Sure.
Do we need that?
Do you know how to play a turn-based RPG?
Yes.
Well, all right then.
No tutorial. Are you certain?
He's talking to you.
Oh, yeah. No tutorial. Are you certain? I know how to play games, Batter!
So you're pretending to be able to handle the bat with virtuosity without even needing my wise pieces of advice? I hope for you that what you state is more than hot air meant to impress me, because that would be taking a high risk. But I will assume that this is not the case, and that you are the fighter of value you claim to be.
I'm good. Good
We're
at
all
things.
Gonna die. Be it as it may, your training has not reached its end yet. Let me ask you to follow me if you still want me as your guide. Bye!
Cat just jumped, man.
Cats jump high.
That's very true.
Ah yes, to pass through here, you need to use your cerebral organ. You know, the one bathing flabbily in your tired cranium.
Ah!
I believe those floating blocks correspond to the symbols you can see on the wall in some way or another. One.
Oops. Oh. Ah, fuff.
One. Two. Sun. She.
This was translated from French. Shouldn't you be saying French?
Sure, I can say French. Je peux parler en français.
I hate you.
Is there a problem, my dear pictorial heroes? I am not your your what?
Genitor?
Genitals?
Genitor.
Genitor? I cannot do everything for you. Nonetheless, may I dare to suggest you wage activating certain ones of these strange floating blocks more than one time, if required. So come, solve this intriguing puzzle for me, and quickly, if you please, I wish to adjoin the ground floor as soon as possible.
Okay, so...
Alright. One... Two... Six? One, two, three, four... So it's the one right under two? Six. The last one. Eight. Back to two. And then three. Yay! We solved the puzzles!
Three!
Aha! Finally, after all that exertion, the eagerly awaited recompense makes its entrance onto the scene. Nom 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 nom.
Is that cute?
Crunch nom 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 crunch 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 nom 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 nom.
Okay, bring that thing up on your phone.
Okay. It's 4-8-2-8-7.
Are these? Wait, these are set up like a phone.
What does the C mean? Is it the bottom one?
I think so.
I don't know. Let's try it out.
Okay. So wait, if these are...
It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. I think so. I don't know.
All right. 1, 2, 3. That's right.
So 4, 4, 8 should be that bottom middle one. 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 and 2 should be that one. And then 8 again.
8.
And then... 7, and then I guess that bottom one. Hey!
Hey!
Cool, we did it! A piece of silver flesh has been found.
Ew.
As much as we love this game, we still kind of suck at the puzzles. Here's an accessory that is going to be especially helpful on your purifying quest, dear enlightened student and sportive friend. It is a cube hovering in midair, as you've likely noticed. Nevertheless, you'll be able to differentiate it from similar ones. By the contents of bad taste it imposes on your view of its clashing color, defying any sensible course of the plastic arts. However, do not judge it too quickly, because despite its criticizable appearance, this red cube is of undeniable use. Aside from rendering you the entirety of your health and competence points, it is capable of saving your progress and sending you into the nothingness. The nothingness is a lieu of transition outside of space itself, where you can travel from one point to another at the speed of light. I now invite you to try it out in order to discover locations more populous than this deserted land. Open your wings, my dear companion, and hurry away towards the following zones without hesitation. Your only enemy is the fear that will grab you.
Woohoo. Okay.
Do not worry. I too travel a lot through the different zones of the world. We will newly meet one another eventually, without a doubt. Ah, by the by, take this. The object of a curious name will be the key that permits you to enter Zone 1. Have I clarified that you can at any time consult your inventory and characteristics by pressing the escape key? The Leo card has been found.
Kitty! Escape. Hey! Okay.
I don't think I've got anything quite yet.
Herald bat.
I'm gonna put that back. Okay. I have Elect Ticket and Silverfish. Recovers monster.
No, Silver Flesh.
And the Elect Ticket does HP. Okay.
Health, save the game. Yay, we're saving. Health points, save the game. Okay.
Alright, here we go.
Wow. This really is nothing.
I go hang out over here with this thing.
It looks like a skull. Sort of. Oh, that's so cool. I really hope this is picking that up. Getting ASMR changes.
It's freaking me out. I need to leave now. Goodbye. Oh, it's green.
And pink.
And raining.
And pink.
I love how the batter walks with such purpose, like dun dun
dun dun dun dun. He's got a sacred mission.
Yeah, sure, why not? Hey, people!
Hey, number one is really useful means of transport to get about zone one.
Get on the thing.
You have to go through the door.
Please select your destination.
Damien?
I guess.
Here we go!
I don't know where else to go. That's cool. Zone 1. I'm in Damien! I don't know what the hell that is.
Train 2 hasn't been active for a long time.
No.
I think I'm gonna give these guys the same voice as Shy Away. A visitor? Welcome to the smoke mines. May I know who you are? Are you an inspector?
Yes. No, I am the batter. I have come to exterminate the impure spirits.
The batter? The impure spirits? Are you some sort of prophet or perhaps a man of belief?
Yeah. Something like that.
Jeez. Love the batter. Who sent you?
God! I mean, no. Well, nobody. I'm being led by Rainbow!
I don't know her. She must be a member of the superior personnel.
Damn right!
In any case, that's good. It means our requests have been acknowledged. Here, I'm going to explain your task.
History lesson! This is a really cool feature. I really like this.
You're at the smoke mines of Damien, the southern part of Zone 1. Here, we send workers into deep tunnels to unearth metal from the ground, freeing embedded smoke that was trapped in the depths. Thanks to a variety of tools, we're able to put some of it into bottles, which the Queen sends to the other zones. The rest of it flows free, forming the air that our lungs inhale and exhale, so we can live!
as the first of four elements, it's an important element.
Elements. It's a strange thing for an element.
Because without smoke, people would have nothing to breathe.
They're saying the same thing in China.
Oh, that's rude. That's rude.
I know, but yeah. I know. Everybody needs to clean up their act. I'm sorry.
You're from LA.
I know. We were the number one leaders for a while.
There we are. And so, finally, how do I put this?
Where are the impures?
Yes, there we go. There are many specters in the mines. They are becoming more and more aggressive. But, in fact, it would be better if you didn't enter the mines because of the regulations forbid visitors to access them. So, here's what we're going to do. There is an annex tunnel that nobody ever goes to. But a miner went in there some time ago, and he saw something strange. He said, nothing like the usual. So I thought, maybe it's the chief of the specters. So, there's your task. If you accept, you'll go into the annex tunnel and kill the chief of the specters. Then the specters will disappear and we can work properly again. There we go. There we, do you have any questions?
No.
Ah, great! Impeccable! The tunnel is right down there. I'll wait here.
I shall fly the coop too.
All right? If this voice is annoying, let me know. Soon I'll be promoted. I'll be supervisor in Alma. Ooh. I'm anxious for that day to arrive.
I like it, but you know.
It's fun to do. I just don't want to be like bad anime voice actor who's trying to be high-pitched voice. You guys know what I'm talking about.
Cat!
Well, who do we have here? Is that not Rainbow and her picturesque jumping jack, the Batter?
He doesn't jump. Are you the Spectre's leader?
No, certainly not. I am only passing through, not unlike the smoke which is being extracted from this place at metallic... this pale and metallic place. However, I believe I know where the one you're looking for and... However, I believe I know where the one you are taking for an ectoplasm can be found. To tell the truth, I am perplexed. I think it is one of those peculiar objects called a spherical add-on. I have very well tried to approach it, but the operation has failed systematically so far. But I'm thinking maybe you, one who does not have a physical order, will succeed in affiliating this spiritual entity to yours.
I have no idea what any of that means either.
I do. Add-on Alpha joined you. Okay, so... the first playthrough we watched this was Markiplier's playthrough, of course.
Yeah.
Was that it?
That's in the game.
Wow, that's cool. And he named his... spoilers, we get three of these add-ons. Was it Oliver, Orville, Oliver, and Oxnard?
Yeah.
Anyway, we have names. This one is Olimar, as in Captain Olimar.
From,
Pikmin.
From Pikmin.
What an exceptionally intriguing phenomenon. I must admit that I remain perplexed by this unexpected metaphysical reaction. Fair enough, since it has decided to accompany you, I know only to advise you to make the best usage possible of it.
Got it. The Chief of Spectres isn't here.
Sorry, but I fear I have to respond in the negative. Apart from this add-on, I have not crossed the way of a single soul in this lieu.
Alright then. Do you have anything else to say?
There's nothing here. This is the sort of spot that I particularly enjoy. What you are looking for is certainly located elsewhere.
Okay. Alright. So I guess we'll stop it here.
Our timer's about to go off.
Yeah, our timer's gonna about to go off, so...
This is the beginning of off. I hope you're intrigued.
I am always intrigued.
Yeah, and I know how it ends.
So we're going to keep this as spoiler-free as possible. If you have seen this or have played it, please try not to spoil it for anybody who hasn't in the comment section. But feel free to discuss if anybody wants to.
If you have played it and you want to discuss like your theories, feel free to do that. Maybe wait for some later videos, but you know.
Yeah.
I'd love to hear what people think of Off. So, I mean, if you want to talk about something that got spoilers in it, maybe just mark it with a spoiler tag, like, spoilers ahead!
Yeah.
Turn back!
Yeah, please. Just be nice to other people. So anyway, we're really excited to play this. This is going to come out along the same time as
Undertale and Earthbound.
So we're kind of going to get the trifecta of these types of games. Earthbound is going to be a lot longer, I guarantee it. Mm-hmm. I'm not really sure how long Undertale is. This game is actually not too long.
This is only like 6 or 7 hours long, which, that sounds like a long time, but in games that's not very long at all.
Yeah, so, arrows. Okay. So, yeah. All right. So, likes, favorites, comments, and subscribes. All the fun stuff helps us grow this channel. Lets us play a lot more games a lot more faster. All of the contact information is in the description below, including Megsy's Patreon. Megsy does all the artwork for the channel, including this awesome title card. Holy crap. And becoming a patron for just $1, you can get a lot of really cool stuff, and that helps us supplement our income a little bit, which helps us buy toilet paper and helps us get more games out there a lot faster. So thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Rainbow, this is Megsy.
Hey.
And everybody, stay sexy. Bye! Bye.